Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, we have looked at the queue data structure. In case of queue data structure, we are going to follow the structure called as first in, first out. Now we will look at the two most important functions which are going to use in the queue. They are insert and delete the element from the queue. Now whenever we are going to insert, it is that we are going to increase the size of the queue. And whenever you are going to delete the element from the queue, what does it mean? We are going to decrease the size of the queue. Let's look at the first function, which is called as insert. So I've defined a function called as public void insert and taken the element I from the user. Now you must remember, in case of queue, we have two variables called as front and rear. So in case of queue, we have front and rear. Now we will check first condition. If rear equal to -1, what it means is that front is not possible. That is, front is also going to be 0, and rear we are going to change it from -1 to 0. So what happens? Front and rear both points to 0th position. That is the first position in the queue. That is your array queue. So what happens is that we are going to point to the position front equal to 0, then rear equal to 0. We are going to shift it to here also. So rear also points to here. Then what we are going to do is point the position of I to Q rear. Let's take I equal to 1. So Q position number 1 will be the position of I. So rear in this case is 0. So what happens? Q 0 equal to 1. So Q rear 0. Okay, this value will be transferred here, and I will be taken from the user. That value is transferred at the position located at rear equal to 0. This is where rear equal to -1. So it is -1, then we are forcefully making it to 0, and then we are going to insert it at position number first. Now let's look at the another possibility. Now what could be another possibility? That already it is full. How do we know? We are going to look it into the consideration of the size of the queue. So if queue rear is not equal to -1, it will be rear +1. If it is greater than the size, or let's say it is equal to the size, let's say we have size equal to 4 and rear is equal to 4. In that case, what happens is that rear will be either 4, or it can also become 4 plus 1, that is 5. So 4 plus 1 5 is greater than or equal to size. True. In that case, what it means is that index out of bound exception occurs, because we have this much size only, we have this much size, and we are going to try to insert the element from another side. That is, we are trying to insert the element out of the bounds of the exception of the array. So we are going to write down an exception called as throw new index out of bounds exception. That means it is a overflow exception. We have already done with the filling up of the size of the array, that is Q. Hence what happens is that we are already trying to insert the element which is already filled up. That is, Q is completely filled up, and we are trying to insert the elements into the queue. That is not going to be possible. How we know this? That is rear +1. Okay, whatever rear is there, +1, or we can say rear +1 is equal to size also, then it is not going to be possible that we can insert the elements. Hence in that case we have a overflow exception. Next we will look at the size where rear +1 is less than size. This condition will be that is rear +1 is less than size. Let's say a case size is 5, rear is at position number 3, or I can say rear is position number 4. So what happens? Rear +1 is less than size. In that case, we can return the length. In that case, what happens? We can return the length, but before returning the length, we need to put up the element into the queue. So what happens? We have rear +1 less than size. Let's look rear at position number 3, and size is 5. So I can insert at 3 plus 1 also. I can insert that 5. So 4 less than 5, true. In that case, what happens? Queue ++ rare. We are trying to first increment the value of rare. Let's say example, rare was at position number 3. Now it will be Q ++ rare. That means Q at position number 4. That position we are going to put up the element called as I, which we have taken the value from the user. Once that is done, then what happens? Since we have added the element into the queue, so obviously length will increase. So length become length plus 1. And how do we write down? Length plus plus. So size automatically increases through the length variable. Now let's have a summary of this. First, we are going to check if rare equal to minus 1. In that case, what we are going to do? We are going to forcefully make front equal to point to the position number 0, and rare is also point to the position number 0. In that case, next will be q rare I. So we are going to insert the element which is coming from the user through I into the first position. Next, we are going to check whether it is already filled up. So we cannot go beyond that. So we are going to check the exception. In that case, we are going to check the condition rare plus 1 greater than equal to size. If it is greater than equal to size, size is 4, let's take the example, and rare is at position number 5. So 5 plus 1, 6, greater than equal to size. What does it mean? We are going to put up the element into the out of bound index. So in that case, the exception is called as index out of bound. That is your overflow exception. And next case, which is where we are going to insert the element as a random position. So now random position, we are going to check it up. Now to check the position, what we are going to do, always make sure that it is always less than the size. So rare plus 1 less than size, just you have to make sure you increment the rare pointer value, or I can say increment the rare variable. So q plus plus rare, first increment the rare variable position and then insert that element into the particular location. Once that is done, then we need to increment the length size, so it becomes length plus plus. Now we will look at the next important function, that is delete an element from the queue. To delete an element from the queue, always we need to check the positions of the front and rear. Let's take a case where we don't have any element present in the queue. So what happens? Is empty comes out to be true. So is it going to be possible that we need to delete the element from the queue? Not possible. So what happens? We cannot delete an element in which there is no element present in the queue. So at least one element needs to be present in the queue to delete that particular element. I've defined a function called as remove. Before going for this, always remember, for removing you need the positions. Now first I will check, is it empty? We have already defined with the function called as isEmpty. So we are look at the if isEmpty function. If it comes out to be true, okay, if it comes out to be true, that means underflow exception has occurred. What does it mean? Is that we are trying to delete an element from the queue in which there are no element present in the queue. If not, that means there is at least one variable, or I can say element, present in the queue which we are trying to delete. Now first we need to decrement the size of the array queue. So what happens? We are going to decrement the size of the array queue. So we have the variable called as length. Now what we need to do is to decrement this size, as we can increment by plus plus. In similar pattern, I can say we can decrement the size of the array queue by writing length minus minus. So we write down length minus minus. Now to delete an element, first we need to have the queue front. Always remember queue front, where it points to point. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to store the value present in the queue front, the position where the front pointer points, the front variable points. That value I'm going to transfer into another variable called as eElement, that is ELE. So I'm going to just transfer that value to the eElement. Now this value is, always remember, it has the front position of the queue. So that value will be transferred to element, that is ELE. Once that is done, we're done with the transformation, then we need to check whether the elements can be deleted or not. Now the position will be where? If front equal to rear. What does it mean? Both front and rear are pointing the only one position which we want to delete. So if front equal to rear, what does it mean? Is that we are trying to delete the element which is at the first position, or in other words, I can say we are trying to delete the element which is only element in the given queue. So in that case, we need to transfer the values back. That is, we need to decrement the value of front and rear. So what I do, I forcefully put up the value of front equal to minus 1 and rear equal to minus 1. Since front and rear both point to the same element. Let's take a case where we have two elements. So what happens? First element will be taken up by the pointing position of the front variable, and second variable will be, that is your rear variable, that is where rear points. So in that case, front and rear will point to two different position. But if there is only one element present, in that case what it means, we need to decrement the value of both front and rear. You must remember that while starting, we start with front equal to minus 1 and rear equal to minus 1. Okay, as and on we move ahead, we add the elements, we increment the front and rear. So if front equal to rear, it means there is only one element present which we are going to delete. Hence front equal to minus 1 we are going to make it sure, and then rear equal to minus 1. If not, what we do is that we delete the element which is at the position number 1, that is front. So what we do, how do we delete that? We just transfer the front to the next position. In other words, I can say we increment the value of front. How do we increment the value of front? But just writing front plus plus. Once front moves ahead, Q will start from the new position of the front and go till the rear. Then what we need to do? Once that is done, just return the element, that is return ELE. Hence, in last case, what we are going to do? We are going to increment the front, and then we are going to return the element, which is ELE. So let's take a summary of this whole topic. We have done with the two functions, insert and remove. While inserting, we are going to check the three conditions, and for removing also we are going to check the three conditions. Now in this case, always remember the position of the front and rear. Hope this concepts clear your in mind, that where the front and rear positions hold the importance in case of cube. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to Ikeda channel.